Hey guys, it's me Marty and welcome back to Diamonds and Denim First Impression Fridays. This week I have the ipsy Maybag to share with you. Look at it. Isn't it pretty? I'm obsessed with it. So if you want to see what I think about each one of these products or how I use them to get this look, you can just keep on watching. Thank you. Okay, y'all. So the first thing I have to review from the May Ipsy Glam Bag is the, excited about this one too, Biorace? I don't know. Intense Hydrating Spirulina Mask. The Ultra Hydrating Sheet Mask that moisturizes dry and dehydrated skin. Okay. So my face isn't that dry since I've been home, but I mean, I'm not opposed to using a sheet mask. It's supposed to be ultra hydrating. When you grab it, you could like feel all the little gel and stuff in it. Like not like, I mean, regular sheet masks have a lot of stuff, but they don't feel, this almost feels like it's just liquid. Like it's so moist. I hate that word, but I don't know another way to say it. Let's open it up. And I usually do this in my bathroom when I do like a remote location, like most ipsy bags, but I'm just tired. I don't want to go in there today. So I'm just going to shoot it right here with the pink background, just like usual. Soothes sensitive, dry, entire skin, deeply absorbs and boosts moisture of skin. Okay. All right. Let's give it a shot. Open it up. Hope it's not too juicy because, I mean, I feel that it's really juicy. Also, something I need to bring up, if you look at the front of it, they have matcha tea on it. I don't know if matcha is an ingredient. I don't see it on the back at all. So the directions are cleanse face, just did that. Unfold the mask and apply to face. Remove mask after 15 minutes. Gently massage to absorb remaining essence. Okay, so this mask comes from Korea. Oh, we already juicy, okay. But you know what I mean. Yes, like really, really one of the wettest sheet masks I've ever encountered. Got a lot of stuff inside. That too, when you are doing a sheet mask, never rinse it off. If you did not know that, don't rinse it off because the whole point, all that extra stuff is in there for you to use. It's not like a, you know. So I would do this as a Sunday spa night situation just because Sunday is the day I relax and try to recharge for the day. Let me say my hands are dry and it is really, really sopping up like so much of the mask and I feel bad. Yeah, because like my hands are sopping up what's supposed to be on my face. Whoop. Oof. Y'all, with the fact that we're under a heat advisory right now, this cold mask, I'm quite obsessed already. I'm glad they sent two. Ipsy, shout out to y'all too for sending two of those, because, I mean, there's really no reason you had to send two except you want me to. So another thing about, I know it's going to be hard to listen to me looking like this, but another thing about masks, sheet masks especially, you want to do it like this. You want to put it on and then use your fingers. Ooh, I'm not ready. It feels so good. Putting it on now, I'm gonna use the extra that's in this little container. There's a lot in there this time. And oh, if you don't know how to get it out, I always do this. I just pull my fingers back and forth. Because again, if I have a mask, especially if I have to pay for it, girl, you can better believe I'm about to get every drop out of that little bag that I can. Okay, so because it's a sheet mask, if I stay here and talk to y'all, it has run the risk of falling off, so I have to go lay down and try to relax 15 minutes. Mask on my head, face. It smells really good too, y'all. So I will go and I will see y'all again in 15 minutes. Okay, y'all, so the 15 minutes is completely up. I don't know if y'all ever noticed, but 15 minutes when you're not doing anything is a long time. I kept waiting for this timer to go off and it like never went off. So I'm going to remove the sheet mask and we will talk about the results. Ugh. Okay, so instantly without even doing anything, you can see how my skin is far more hydrated than it was. I'm gonna again take out the extra juice, see what else is left in here. And I'm sorry, that's just like a money saving thing, even though I didn't pay for it separate. I don't know when I'm gonna get this mask again, so I'm going to continue to slather my face in it. It was so hydrating, but the only issue with that is I'm kind of nervous about it because I was supposed to do my makeup right after this. And I don't feel like with all this stuff on my face that any of it is going to stick. So I'm going to have to take a longer break and just do it. Do the makeup portion of this later. But I mean, like I said, you can literally see my face is shiny like it's wet. Like this is definitely the most hydrating sheet mask I've ever used. I know my mom will take a Ziploc bag and put the rest of her sheet mask in it. Oh my God, there's so much in here. So already major shout out to Biorace, I don't know. Putting so much in that one little envelope, like that's insane. Honestly, I think there's more in the bag, but I am so saturated. Yeah, I love this stuff, I really do. So it's so hydrating. I'm not gonna do a moisturizer. I also have this Pixi Skindrink Pure Hydration Gel to put in, to test out today too. but I'm gonna push that to another day just because my skin is so hydrated now. I don't think it would give it a fair shake. Just like I said, it's just so hydrated. So that's the hydrating mask from BioRace. And actually, now that it's soaking into the skin a good bit, so that means that I will be able to do my makeup today. So that's good. And my skin just feels so much. I wish I would have had that right out of the hospital, because that would have worked really, really good. But I mean, something else I think would be nice is if you put it in the refrigerator. Like the other ones that they gave too, I'm gonna stick the other one in the fridge. They need to come out, I don't know, maybe it's just me. They need to come out with something like this before your feet. Like that would make my life so good if they could just do that for me. So anyway, so that's that. I'm gonna put this away and we'll get started on my face in just a second. Okay, so now my brows are done. My face and eyes are primed. So the next step is going to be, the next product I should say is gonna be another one of my favorites, SL Miss Glam makeup brush. So this one is so cute because it's got these little glitters all over inside of it. Y'all know your girl likes some glitter and I like some sparkle. My dad makes fun of me for it all the time. It's like, somebody got some glitter in this house, I know it's hers. It's all over the place. My wrapping paper for Christmas was glitter. I love glitter and I'm not embarrassed to admit it, honey. This is a SL Miss Glam SS57 brush. And again, it's in this pretty like confetti kind of thing. So SL Miss Glam, since I've had Ipsy, they give a brush all the time. Like I've had so many SL Miss Glam brushes. And the thing with it is all of them are good. I've loved every single one of them I had. Now this one in particular, I'm gonna use the eyeshadow brush. I'm pretty sure that's what it's meant for. I'll check on Ipsy and see if that's right. But this, I mean, this could be like your one eyeliner brush you use. Like you would use a puffy one to do your all over color. This could be a transition, your crease. It could be like all of your non-lid work. So all of the above lid work would fit great here. So anyway, so let's do that. Okay, so I'm gonna actually do the Elizabeth Mod brush just to put my base colors. Then I'm gonna start with transitions using the new SL Miss Glam brush. And for my look today, just in case anyone cares, I am using the original Tarte lip palette. See, I love this palette, it's so good. It smells good, it's one of my favorite palettes I've ever gotten actually. This is not about the palette, this is about the brush. So let's start. I'm gonna dip into Dreamer with this beautiful brush. That's gonna be my transition shade. Wow, the color's so pigmented. Every time I use that palette, it shocks me at how pigmented it actually is. Okay, that brush is actually more direct than I thought it was. I thought it was gonna be one that I could use like as a fluffy brush. It's really not that fluffy. I mean, it's fluffy, but okay, so after using this as a transition shade, I think it's very the bristles for some reason are more concentrated than I thought they were. So it seems like see how my eyeshadow, well no, not now, it looks good, but it was splotchy a little while ago, so I had to kind of work on it. But that happens usually when you have either too much primer on and it grabs onto every little piece of eyeshadow you have. But in this case, I'm pretty sure I just misjudged the brush. I thought it was gonna be a wider brush, but it's more for focusing on little areas. So like a crease, it's gonna be an amazing crease brush when it gets to that amazing crease brush. So as a matter of fact, I'm about to do my crease now. So let me do my crease. Again, using the same brush. Next, I'm going to go in with Multitasker for a very, very, it's gonna be a kind of dark crease, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm just gonna tap it in there because that's a really dark shade. I don't wanna do a lot. You can see it on the brush. So this white part catches a whole lot of pigment. I don't really know what the blue part is for, but I know the white part is catching some pigment like there's no tomorrow, so let's see. Yeah, it's really dark and not really hard with this brush. So again, I'm taking this brush. I just kind of stamped where I wanted my crease to start, and now I'm just going into the socket. Yeah, and see, because it's such a dark crease color, I don't have to spread it around that much, so it's gonna be it for this crease color. So this is the eye look so far. I'm going to blend it out a little bit. Not using this brush. This brush is not good for blending. It's really good for applying something straight on. I call those target brushes. Like right where it wants to hit, it hits the target. So that's why I call it a target brush. Okay, y'all. So I'm back for the rest of the May Ipsy Glam Bag. I'm just about done. You can see I'm just about finished. So I did use mascara, but I did not use falsies. I used the Troublemaker mascara from Urban Decay. Anyway, so our next item in the May Ipsy Glam Bag is the Radiant Glow Highlighter by IBY Beauty. It's called 24 Karat Magic. So before I even get into the product itself, let's look at the box, because the box is like everything. To say, and I talk about this all the time, but if you give a sample to Ipsy, I want you to give it to me like I've never heard of you before and I've never seen you before. I'm not familiar with your brand, which in this case I'm actually not. But I can look at this box and just know that they are about something. Like, I know that this brand is not playing around. So the box, the packaging is really, really nice. They have something on every side. Y'all know how I feel about that. On the back, it gives a lot of information about the product itself. It says 24 karat magic. So after open the box is just white on the inside, but I'm not mad at it. They gave protection in the thing. Oh, that's so cute. So they put it in this foam thing to protect it, to make sure it didn't get smushed. Oh, this compact. Okay, so this is the compact. It's so pretty. I don't know if y'all can see. You can kind of see my ring light reflecting off it. It's a real glossy compact. It's so cute. On the back, it says IBY Radiant Glow Highlighter 24 Karat Magic, not tested on animals, designed in Los Angeles. So this, I mean, IBY, I gotta tell y'all, whoever y'all are, I'm not familiar with the brand, but it's a really, I like it. Gave me a glance into what the company is about, and from this glance, that company is about that life. Okay, so here's the inside of it. It's a really cute compact. Again, it doesn't have a mirror, but I mean, it's so tiny. What am I gonna look at in a mirror that size? I got so much respect for this brand right now. So this is the highlighter itself. It's really pretty. It's like a gold color. It reminds me of either 24 karat in the Anastasia Beverly Hills highlight contour powder. It reminds me of that 24 karat. It also reminds me of the Blissful Ofra highlighter, which is like my favorite highlighter of all time. So let me do a little tiny swatch. Okay, the texture is different though. It almost feels wet. Like, it's really cool. So this is the highlighter swatch. So you can see we are giving it, okay? It's giving it to you. It's not a really soft, I mean, I don't know. I'll have to see what it looks like on my face right now. On my wrist, it looks like it'll be a blinding highlight. I don't know what it's gonna look like on my face though. So let's find out. This is my Japanese brush. It is originally a blush brush, but ever since I got it, I literally bought it because I thought it'd be a good highlighter brush. And thus far it hasn't disappointed me. So let me apply that. That's a good, for a sample, that's a good amount too. Okay, let's see. We're gonna do this together. Okay, yeah, it's pretty. It's not as blinding as Ofra or anything like that, but it's very pretty. It's one I can see I'm gonna use a lot. And like I said before, you can see it's definitely class all the way. Yeah, it's gorgeous. I love this. This is really pretty. Like, when I run out of this little one, I'm considering going online and buying the big one, like going to their website. And highlight is good. It's not, I mean, I wouldn't personally consider blinding, but it is pretty. You see it's there, but this would be like, for me, honestly, and I know it's gonna sound horrible, this would be like an everyday highlight for me, because it's just really, it's bright, it's popping, but it's not like, ah, and I like, ah, when I'm talking blinding highlights. But the packaging, like, the company is amazing. I love it, so. Okay, people, so I am just about done. I went ahead and finished my look, jewelry, and, you know, hair and all that jazz is done. I have one, well, technically I have two more products in the May Ipsy Glam Bag. But remember the Pixi H2O, since we did the mask, I decided to push that for the next one. So I'll throw y'all to that at the end, and then y'all can see how that looks. But for right now, my next one is a velvet liquid lipstick. Ooh. But it says matte, long-lasting, and moisturizing. Matte, long-lasting, and moisturizing. I think that's like an oxymoron. I don't think you can have a matte that's moisturizing, but we'll try. A velvet liquid lipstick. They have their information at holaneon.com/holaneon, all that stuff. So I'll put that on the thing at the bottom so that y'all can see the website if you want to check them out. And it is a velvet liquid lipstick in the shade FOMO. So first of all, before I even get to that, I like how the packaging on this lipstick, it's so pretty. I almost want to leave it in it. I'm not familiar with that brand. Again, it looks like it's just from Illinois, so it's from here. I don't know. I've never heard of it or seen it before, but anyway. So this is the velvet liquid lipstick, matte, long lasting, and moisturizing in FOMO. So let's see what it looks like. The box is so pretty. That bottle better be beautiful, because I'm gonna have some questions. On the inside, it says, hola, babe. Oh, that's so cute. Y'all know me and extras like that. And it's got some little emoji eyes right here. Can y'all see it? So cute. Okay, yeah, it's gorgeous. I mean, it's the same as the backdrop, just about. That's cool. But anyway, it's so here's the package, the bottle itself. I mean, it looks like a jewel. It's got this gold top, gold writing. gold on the bottom. On the bottom it says FOMO. I like it. Look at it. It reminds me of the Christian Dior lipstick. Not nearly as pricey, I'm sure. So let's check it out. Let me swatch it first. I washed it off. Right here with it. And... oh. Pretty. It's like a raspberry fuchsia color, which I'm not mad at. I mean, I don't have a use for a raspberry fuchsia right now since it's not the fall. But I guess it's cute to have a berry pop of color during the summer. Okay. You know, that's something you need to check with a lipstick, obviously. Okay, the applicator is really good. It's allowing me to like almost draw a line, but you know, it looks clean. It's because the top is pretty pointed that it's allowing me to like outline my lips first. Okay, now supply, so I'm gonna let it sit for like a minute so it can set up real good. For those of you who don't know, if you use a liquid lipstick, it's not just gonna come out of the box and be ready to wear. You gotta let it sit for a second. So I think that's probably it for this lipstick. It should be pretty dry. But y'all know here on Diamonds Denim, we don't play favorites, so still not dry, then it's still not dry. I don't know what the deal is with this. So that's the lipstick, that's the color. It is like the exact color of the backdrop, which I think is so weird. Let's see the kiss test. It's been a couple minutes now, so let's check the kiss test. Oh, the kiss test, nothing came off. Yeah, kiss test, nothing came off, so that's good. The swatch, okay, no, nothing came off, so very good, very good. Good for you, because I really didn't want to give it a bad review. It was so pretty. Okay, so this is the finished look. Everything is done. I've now tried out all the products in the bag, so I'm very excited about that. Almost all of them. I have one missing, but I'm going to throw y'all to that at the end, because I just, like I said, the sheet mask I did was so good, I don't feel like I could do both of them in the same setting. So let me actually talk to y'all about that. Okay, so guys, let's talk about each of the products and stuff. We're gonna give it a diamond or not for the whole entire bag. So first off, before we get started, let's look at the bag itself, because I always wanna look at the bag. I mean, they made up for the January bag so much with this bag, because this bag is amazing. I love this bag. You can't really see it on there, but it's almost like a rosy gold. Like a rose gold color. It looks just gold to me on camera, but it's not. It's like, it's got all this pink in it. It's so pretty. I have a nail polish that's like the same exact shade. So I'm obsessed with the bag itself. Let's get into product by product. This, okay, first, before I even start, this and these, this is the product that I haven't been able to review today because of this product. So this is the Pixi Skindrink H2O Skin Drink. I actually got to pick this one out on ipsy. They started this new thing where they give you the five products and then you have the option of picking, they give you four products and you have the option of picking out of a certain amount, out of a certain couple of products, which one you want. So I chose the Pixi Skindrink, the Pixi Skindrink H2O Skin Drink Pure Hydration Gel. I didn't use it today because I used this product today, so you don't really need both. Like, this product made my skin so wet that I didn't want to put more moisture on it. I felt like I wouldn't have got a fair shake. So the first, so I'm going to put this back in the bag because we're going to use it another time. I'll throw y'all to it at the end. So this is the Bio Rase, I don't know how it's pronounced, Intense Hydrating Spirulina Mask. Spirulina Mask hydrates, replenishes, and calms skin. Bomb, y'all. Look, okay, I don't have a lot of sheet masks that I love. I try sheet masks all the time. I love a good sheet mask, but this thing was amazing. Like, it took me forever to even let it just soak in where I could start applying my makeup. So I did this, and then I let it soak into my face. I put it all over my body because it was so liquidy, my skin was like saturated with it. So I had to take it, I put some on my elbows, put some on my hands. Bomb. I mean, if your skin is dry, if you have oily skin, I wouldn't do this because it's so hydrating. It might cause you to break out and my clog your pores up, but this thing is amazing. I can't wait to try cold. It's so hot outside that like when I get in, I would do a sheet mask any day of the week because it's just that doggone hot. So I'm gonna take this one, I'm gonna actually put it in the microwave. No, sweetie, I'm gonna put it in the refrigerator and just see, you know, what happens with it. Selma's Glam Brush. It was an eyeshadow brush. Of course I love it. It's a good blender. Selma's Glam's brushes very rarely disappoint me. They're really, really good. This one is very, very pigmented. It's these lighter colors. It catches so much of whatever you're applying. Like mine was my eyeshadow. I wound up having to mostly use it for the crease, and that's probably what I'm gonna wind up using it for, because even though it looks like it's got, like the bristles are kind of spread apart, they're really not when you apply it. They're pretty close together and they hold a lot of pigment. So it's like a target brush. Like wherever you put it, it's gonna stick there. So make sure if you plan to do like a big old swatch with it, very careful, because it will really make your situation very, very pigmented. So I put that back in the bag. the Radiant Glow Highlighter by IVY Beauty. I can't say enough good things about this product. Between the packaging of it and the actual product itself, I said when I was applying it that it wasn't really a blinding highlight. Now that I'm done, I changed my mind. It is pretty blinding. Like, if you see how my skin looks like I'm sun-kissed, like I've been outside all day, it's because of this. It gives you a really pretty glow. Open it up, show you the actual highlighter itself. Again, this is the highlighter itself, a little compact. So gorgeous. I'm obsessed with this, so definitely something I'll be going back to. And last but not least, the Ola Neon Velvet Liquid Lipstick. This is the lipstick, it's very pretty. The actual bottle itself though is beautiful. I mean, it's so pretty. It's a really pretty berry color. It did stay on after I applied it. It passed the kiss test with no marks left. It's just a really good product and I really, 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 really like it. So it's just, I really like it. So I would definitely give this one a diamond if I was doing it individually. Again, this is not including the skin drink from Pixi. I just want to make sure y'all understand I'm not trying to pass this off as a finished bag because the skin drink is still not done. But if I had to judge just based off of the four products I have and the bag, for sure, May gets a diamond. I mean, it looks like a diamond with all the glitter and everything, but it's just so, everything in it, I'm seeing myself using over and over and over again. Again, that's not including the skin drink. I'm gonna throw to that in a second, but I love this bag. Definitely, I would say it gets a diamond. So I'm gonna throw y'all over to the skin drink, the Pixi H2O skin drink section. Okay, people, hey, it's me, Marty, and I am back with the last selection in the May Ipsy Glam Bag. So the last thing, and you remember last time I did a mask right before it and my skin was so wet I didn't want to put a moisturizer on it, so I held this till now. This is the, Louis highly upset. Oh my God, all the dogs are talking. So anyways, I was saying, the Pixi Skin Treat since 1999. This is the Pixi H2O Skin Drink, Pure Hydration Gel. So I'm assuming that this is like a moisturizer, intense moisture gel, instantly rehydrates dry skin. Okay. So having that in conjunction with that, the mask I just did is probably gonna leave my skin super duper soft today. Is my eyeliner? This again was the last thing in the Ipsy, the March Ipsy Glam Bag. I mean, I'm sorry. May Ipsy Glam Bag, this beautiful shiny one, and I'm going to try the skin drink. Oh. And something important about the skin drink, they let me choose this product. I got to pick one of my five items, and I picked this one because I've been hearing about Pixi Beauty for a long time. I've used a couple of their things, but I've never used their skin stuff, so I was excited to try this. So, okay. So they just have a little, first of all, I like the packaging. I like the rose gold writing. I like all of Pixi's packaging though. They do a good job with that. Pulling off the little silver thing. Just a little moisture gel. Kind of reminds me of the Skin 11 moisturizer that I love. Oh yeah, okay, it's super duper. I already feel like it's really hydrating and I just started doing it. So I'm just gonna rub it into my face. I don't know if I really need a mirror for this, but I had one handy, so why not? I mean, Ipsy, moisturizer wise, y'all have been killing the game with moisturizer. Like, this is bomb. So I'm gonna go do my makeup and then I'll come back with to y'all and kind of explain to y'all how I feel about this. I mean, y'all can guess I like it already, but I'm not gonna leave y'all with me looking like this. I'll do it later. We'll come back and talk about it later. So I just wanted to kind of talk to y'all about that one because I just used it today and I really, really like it. It's really good. It's like a gel and it just slid over my skin and it was really, really good. I just, like I said, I just really liked it. Super hydrating, really liked it. So I used it today underneath all this makeup and it was just good. I like it a lot. I just wanted to come through and say that and add that to the May Ipsy Glam Bag review. So thank you so much. Please look at the corresponding blog link below if you want to check out any more information about these products or like a more in-depth. I will see y'all next week. Bye.